Grace and peace to you, friends. Both those of you who are part of our community of faith here at St. Paul's, as well as those who may be joining us online for the first time. This is the first time that we have ever live streamed our entire service online, so we hope that you will please bear with us and forgive any mistakes that we make. I would especially like to say a big word of thanks to Gail Tabor, who has given her time and technical skills to help us get to this point. Like many people all across the world, really, we have been scrambling over these past few days to try to figure out ways to remain connected, even as we practice the social distancing that has been recommended by medical professionals and health experts. We have not suspended our in-person meetings out of any sense of fear, but rather out of a sense of faithfulness as followers of Christ. Although most people are not going to contract the virus, and most people who contract the virus will be just fine, our greatest concern as followers of Christ is always for the least of these, always for those who are most vulnerable. And these steps have been taken to assure their well-being. Even though we are socially distancing ourselves right now, we are still united as one in Christ, seeking the good of all and ensuring that our hospitals, clinics, and medical professionals are able to do the jobs that they've been called to do because they're not overwhelmed with cases that did not need to be there. As a wise person has said, in the end, it will be impossible to know if we overreacted or did too much. But it will be quite apparent if we underreacted or did too little. While it may be frustrating, especially for those who are extroverts, I encourage you to explore this as a practice of Sabbath, a time of worship and rest and renewal. I've been inspired this week by this poem called Pandemic by Lynn Unger. What if you thought of it as the Jews consider Sabbath, the most sacred of times? Cease from travel. Cease from buying and selling. Give up, just for now, on trying to make the world different than it is. Sing. Pray. Touch only those to whom you commit your life. Center down. And when your body has become still, reach out with your heart. Know that we are connected in ways that are terrifying and beautiful. You can hardly deny it now. Know that our lives are in one another's hands. Surely that has come clear. Do not reach out your hands. Reach out your heart. Reach out your words. Reach out all the tendrils of compassion that move invisibly where we cannot touch. Promise this world your love, for better or for worse, in sickness and in health, so long as we all shall live.
Thank you. say.